The 2024 Mitre 10 Mega Masterton New Zealand Cycle Classic will once again see riders from across the world converge on Wairarapa for 5 days of international stage racing. The 37th edition has 15 teams which will compete on the roads around the winery district before racing the final stage in New Zealand's capital, Wellington. Since its inception in 1988, the tour has seen several champions successfully compete at the highest levels of the sport. These have included the likes of Robbie McEwen, Julian Dean, Richie Port, George Bennett, and Corbin Strong. At the end of the week, who will add their name to the illustrious list of winners of New Zealand's only UCI 2.2 sanctioned race? At around 30 kilometres into the stage, a break of six riders finally managed to get clear of the peloton, at times opening a gap of around 2 minutes. Bentley Nicu Olden of the Keishi Parkoop team was keen to be part of this group as he picked up points in the first two King of the Mountain climbs to ensure his team retained the polka dot jersey. However, as the leaders approached the 80k mark, the cohesion amongst them began to falter, and in the end it was the familiar figure of Campbell Pithy at the front solo before he was caught by a dwindling peloton. As the field turned onto Admiral's Road, a small group launched off the front, which included three riders from Bridge Lane team, three from the Southern Cross Academy Racing, last year's stage victor Josh Burnett, Logan Curry, and his team leader Aaron Gates. A number of challenges were attempted in the closing meters, but in the end, it was the yellow jersey who kicked clear to take his second stage of this year's tour and continue the dominance of the New Zealand national team.
Well, Drew, welcome back again to New Zealand. You've done this a few times now, and yesterday, a challenging circuit.
Yep, second year here, and second year here with Kinan, which is good. It's a race that they really enjoy coming to and starting the season. It's perfect for them and for us. I always come here with good condition after the Nationals, so it works for me. Yesterday's a tough little circuit, Queen Stage, always one that I look forward to.
And of course today it flips to a relatively flat sort of a circuit out there, and a bit of unknown for a lot of riders.
I haven't done this circuit before, not too sure what to expect. I don't think there's too much wind around, but if that picks up, obviously that will be a big part of it.
All right, well, Sam, Rust Valley Ridley, and that's pretty prominent. Yesterday, I'd be pleased with the way things transpired for them.
Yeah, it was pretty good to get Eli up in the break, you know, it's what we wanted, and you know, we've struggled to place someone in the break, so to be able to do it. The final climb wasn't quite what we'd hoped, but today's another day, so.
Well, we're joined here by Oliver Grave, who had an outstanding day out there on the road yesterday. You've got to be pretty pleased with the way things went.
Yeah, pretty happy. Went pretty close to exactly what I wanted out of the day, so doesn't get much better than that, really. Just didn't get much of a leash out there, so everyone were kept in check. We had to ride hard all day, so made for a tough one.
And you're in a team here that's giving an opportunity for a lot of New Zealand riders to experience the top racing.
Yeah, a lot of young guys from the track and the road getting to do all the top level racing around, and a lot of them heading over to Europe this year and stuff, so great opportunities.
Fairly flat sort of a circuit, just one climb.
I think it's the main dangers are really the crosswinds today, so if it does get a bit windy, which it doesn't look like it is now, but yeah, no. That's more of a worry than the climb for me, to be honest.
And the iBuilt team themselves, tell us a bit about those guys.
So it's just a bunch of young guys that are getting a bit of experience in a UCI race, which is always good. And I think, we're all working pretty well together. So if we can keep that up, we should be all right to the end.
All the best.
Thank you.
The penultimate stage in this year's tour sees the riders contest 122 kilometres around the Carrington Circuit within the Carterton District. New to many of the riders, the stage will have them race a figure eight type of course, which is relatively flat, but with plenty of changes of directions and narrow roads to offer the opportunity for a break to sneak off the front. Two KOM and two sprints are on offer for the respective classifications. Locals will be able to enjoy the race close up as it circulates the course four times over the day, and with 24 seconds covering the top 20 riders, every opportunity to take seconds will count. So the penultimate stage here of this year's tour of 122 kilometres. As we've mentioned, a new circuit here for these riders, not only just for the riders, but for a few of the officials as well, and that sort of figure eight type sort of scenario for these riders. The wind at the moment, not really that prevalent, but I know a number of riders, talking to them prior to the stage here, were hoping it would pick up because, of course, that would allow for the ability for the brakes to be able to happen if they could put them into the gutter a bit, as we see the first attempts trying to go off the front. And it looks like Bailey O'Donnell, the Oxford Edge rider, he's one of the men in contention for the sprint ace, so no surprise to see him up towards the front. George Jackson there, he'll be put into the mission of getting off the front and looking at what's going on up there, checking out who's in contention, who are the threats. He won't necessarily be there to try and lap it out, just keeping a close eye on it for his team leader and the man in yellow, Aaron Gape. But very quickly, these riders open up about a 15-second gap there in the first few kilometres as they make their way onto the back of the circuit. A circuit which they'll do some four times through Carterton here, around the Carrington circuit. It looks like it's going to be a pretty impressive sort of a race here in terms of the narrow roads that are available for these riders, the twisting and the turning, and if the winds were to pick up, that could be all the determining factors to allow a group to try and get themselves off the front, because they could become out of sight, out of mind. And you can see Bailey O'Donnell, he's very keen to try and get things heading along here, but a number of teams are represented. A couple from the Mitre Q team. You can see them, number 72 and 71, Josh Burnett up there. We've also got a St. George Continental team in the mix there as well. And here we go, is another one of those teammates there of Josh Burnett, number 72. There going off to the front is Craig Oliver, the mountain biker, and that's getting off the front. Now, this guy has won national titles. He has ridden internationally in the mountain bike scene. He rode in the SBS Bank Tour of South on his first ever tour only a few months ago and was riding extremely well. So good to see him off the front. USA keen to try and see what they can do now, as it looks like the O'Donnell group have come back into the fold. But no rest for the wicked whatsoever, as Copeland's now go on to the front and they put some serious pressure on. And there you go, you can see the polka dot jersey hanging on, trying to make sure that he stays handy to it, because of course there is two KOMs here today. The same climb each time, and that over a couple of the laps of the four that they do here. So they'll just be looking to ensure that they can pick up a few points if need be, or ensure really that there is no serious threats to go up the road to try and take that jersey, because today is the final day of which the KOM will be decided. A small group again now starting to form, and again familiar colours, not necessarily the same riders, they're going on to the front with the likes of Oxford Edge again. The Americans have made it to the connection here. One or two of the national team also keeping a close eye on things. It was, you see them starting to splinter. It just takes a little bit to try and settle into it, try to establish itself as riders scramble across as the high speeds here. The first 20 minutes of the stage already we can see that they have raced close on 50 kilometers an hour. So these guys are not mucking about whatsoever as they make their way down this long straight around the outskirts of Carterton here. As I said, a new circuit. They have used part of it a long time ago, but really, in essence, the entire circuit is all brand new to the riders here as they come off the top of the climb and down a little bit of a descent. As I said, not a huge amount of elevation as you would have seen at the top of the show there with the graphics, as these riders now come back into the fold. And furthermore, we see a bit of a stretch of three or four riders trying to get themselves off the front. And again, it is Bailey O'Donnell who's decided he's going to hit himself off the front. Who's he going to go with this time? St. George is in there. Keenan this time in there. Keenan Cycling, the team based out of the Japanese team with a couple of Aussies in there. And that looks like Ryan Kebner that has made the junction across. Now, this is looking more serious here as we can see the gap starting to open up. Christensen this time round on the back there. He's the man holding the tickets, keeping a close eye on things. Ryan is a fantastic domestique for the team. He's now sitting in there with this group. He won't be expected to do anything because, of course, his man is the man in the yellow jersey. And when he does, he'll just roll through, do what he has to, nothing too serious, as he ensures that these guys here are kept well and truly under control. So again, it will take them a few kilometers just to settle into it and decide if they can actually work as a strong unit, as the gap opens now to around 42 seconds. So this will make things interesting back in the main peloton. They'll be doing the numbers, working out exactly who's up in front, what sort of threat are they as we make their way up one of the little bit of bumps on the particular circuit here for these riders here today. See a bit of movement in the trees as the wind slowly starts to pick up for them here at this point in time. And of course, it's 122 kilometres here on this penultimate stage. These guys are having to back it up after a tough day yesterday in the hills, and there was a lot of tired looking riders out there this morning, first thing as they are getting in for the sign on. And of course, the fatigue factor, and let alone dealing with the heat, is really starting to kick in for one or two. So five riders now looking a lot sharper with it here as they roll into things. And right towards the rear of the group, you can see Tom Sexton, number 13. He is, of course, one of the New Zealand track representatives. He's a very good bike rider, been riding for the Black Spoke team, and he certainly knows how well to ride a bike, both on the track and on the road. So good to see him up the front there for the St. George Continental team. As we can see, it's evident here in the main peloton that the speed is on when we see the single file. And they're picking up a bit of a tailwind and going at some 65k an hour, which of course ensures that the front group have to be doing at least that if they want to keep this group away. And who's the man right at the front ensuring that the pace is kept high? The man in yellow himself. He won't necessarily be looking for the stage victory. He's got the likes of your George Jacksons, your Karen Watts, who they might be trying to set up for today, because it's an ideal sort of a stage for them as they come through the finishing area. And you can see they'll be checking this out with this long straight to ensure that they know exactly how it's done, and that they're fortunate with the fact that they have four laps and that they can check out exactly the camber of the road, the corner coming into it there, to know exactly where they could set themselves up ideally if they were to come home as a bunch kick. So a number of teams making their way towards the front, but slotting in behind the national team, a 50-second gap. Now, this is starting to stretch a bit here. Now, Bailey O'Donnell, remember, not only is he out there looking for that sprint ace, but this guy comes in at 16th overall in the general classification at only a minute 25 down. So he, at the moment, if this group were to start to stretch it a bit further here, he could become the virtual leader on the road. So hence why Gate & Co. will be keeping this in check. They'll be well aware that Bailey is trying to steal some more points here for the Wiz Wireless Sprint Ace, because there is a number of riders, as I mentioned at the top of the show here, that are vying for this particular competition here. He comes in here sitting in third, so I think it is overall in the Sprint Ace. And currently you've got Gate himself and Camden Faint, who are both tied on 15 points apiece as they roll through, and they literally do just roll through for the King of the Mountains, because for all of these guys here, they'll pick up a few points, but it won't make any difference because that jersey has been sewn up already by the Keishi team, and that's who have got it well and truly sewn up here, and are quite pleased that these guys, that's why they're not in there in this particular break, they know that they are of no threat to that particular jersey. So these guys are settling down for it now, looking to try and get themselves the stage victory, as we see a fantastic drone piece of footage here. And again, you can see the yellow jersey sitting at about 5 wheels back there, keeping himself nice and safe towards the front, a close eye on things. Believe it or not, here we are having a sprint. This is the Wiz Wireless sprint available here. There's a couple of them. Again, these riders, they've already agreed. They know there's only one man in contention for it here. They don't want to waste any energy. So Bailey gets to pick that up. And he's picked up a number of points along the way here. And he will be pushing himself further up the leaders board. And potentially, if he can hold off, and that's the charge here of this main peloton, he could move himself into the green jersey. Not forgetting, of course, even if they were to be caught, there are still points up for grabs in the stage finish as well. So he's giving it absolutely everything. As we see the Kenan rider, number 42, he's been driving it along quite a bit here today. Great to have these guys back over. There have been a number of times over the years, Kenan cycling team. Fantastic to have them. They've got a great support crew. I know their social media are well supportive here of this tour. As we see Bailey & Co. along with Ryan Kebner, and they're congratulating each other. Good effort, mate. We'll sit up and we're going to head on back as Kebner decides to head back. And you can see that yellow figure of the tour leader towards the front. Bailey O'Donnell continues to carry it on with Toby Evans of Copeland's. This young man, he's done an outstanding stage here. He's been riding over in France for the past 12 months. He's one of the younger riders here in this year's tour, and he's looking to head back over to France again in 2024. So this has been a fantastic effort for him to be off the front today with some high caliber riders here, showing them how it's done. The Hawke's Bay rider, but it looks like it's going to be to no avail here, as on this last half lap or so for these riders, they have come back into the fold. And a few others now, Pista Corsa cycling here will now try and get themselves off the front and try and see if they can make some sort of difference, with Joel Douglas, the man in the Pista Corsa development team.
He gets himself briefly off the front here, but I would suggest, yep, as the pictures show, he'll get himself sucked back in because there are other teams who want it to be a sprint finish. Bridge Lane, right up there towards the very front of the race. Of course, they've got Matthew Greenwood, number 55, second recently in the under-23 Australian National Championships. Elliot Schultz sits currently second overall in the general classification. It is the other Australian team also up towards the front, as we saw there in those sort of purpley colours. Team we've mentioned a lot, the Casey Park Hoop team. But now the riders spread themselves across the roads here, and the power is starting to be put down by one or two teams, and they'll stretch them out, making life difficult for riders to establish themselves into that final corner, because that's where they all want to be here, because it's going to be a tight one turning into that final one based on what we've seen over the last three laps. This is their fourth and final lap here for these riders, and you can see now the Kiwi contingent, the national team, start to really pick the pace up. Can George Jackson pick himself up a stage here today? And it's the tour leader himself, Aaron Gate, that's going to lead them down into the finishing stretch. He's a tight bend there, as you can see riders peeling on off. He's lining up George Jackson. Oh no, there's been a crash midway down the straight, and it looks like George Jackson and a handful of other riders have hit the deck hard. So it is now up to the likes of Gate & Co. to try and take on the challenge at the front. And it looks like it's going to be a challenge he's going to take on with a vengeance, as Aaron Gate takes out the win. Bailey O'Donnell into second place, and Adam Chapman of Rushfellow Ridley, a fine sprint for him to secure a third, as Aaron Gate takes his third stage in this year's tour. He'll be very concerned though by the fact that he's lost a couple of teammates and a heavy fall down that finishing straight. But the national team continue 100% record, taking every stage thus far.
Well, congratulations, Aaron. Another stage victory.
Yeah, thank you. Definitely. I know I said it was a surprise yesterday, but today definitely was a surprise. I was all in for George. I unfortunately heard, you know, some chains drop and what I thought was some sliding carbon, unfortunately, behind me. So I was like, okay, I'll just have to tether this a bit, hope he's still there, and just give it a final drive to the line. And unfortunately, it didn't come past, but fortunately, no one else did. And yeah, hopefully George is all right, because he lost some skin there today, and hopefully he'll pull up all right to try and get him up finally tomorrow.
And of course, coming into this stage, and it continues, it's very tight at the top there. I think it was 24 seconds in the top 10 coming into this stage, and we had a couple of guys like Zakavna, Bailey O'Donnell off the front.
Yeah, that headwind up Admirals yesterday was pretty unprecedented in terms of how close this race has been across the board, with so many guys still in contention. So it's definitely, the race is far from done, and it's going to be pretty fast and relentless crit in Wellington tomorrow, which should be a good one to watch.
And it's a unique experience, isn't it, for the crowds to come out and see such racing?
Yeah, it's awesome. It's something you don't really get a chance to see anymore in New Zealand, tight circuit racing that really just puts a real emphasis on how fast we can go around the circuit like that. So I think it's definitely worth anyone who's keen to come out and see a bike race. It's I know it's what inspired me when I was first started racing, was seeing Sarah Ulmer rip around a Criterium circuit in Auckland. So this is hopefully some inspiration for the young bucks coming up through the ranks too.
Well, congratulations again for today, and all the best for tomorrow.
Thank you very much.
Well, congratulations, Liam. Two sprints available today for that King of the Mountains, but you guys have done enough to secure it.
Yeah, it's a nice feeling. We were really concerned today that someone from Southern Cross Racing would get up the road and try and challenge the points. So we were looking for the move. It didn't eventuate, but there was no one in the move that was of serious concern. So that's a nice feeling to sold up.
And it was quite challenging out there. That wind picked up as the stage went on, and some very high speeds.
Yeah, it was a really fast start. I think we averaged close to 48 k's an hour for the first hour. And it was really hard to get into the move and the move of the day. So, look, to have it sewn up now is a big relief. And, look, we can go down to Wellington tomorrow and enjoy the crit.
And, of course, Australians are renowned for crit racing, so you'll be looking forward to it.
Yeah, and it's funny because normally I would say I like a good crit, and probably not used to wearing the King of the Mountains, which is quite ironic. But yeah, it'll be really nice to get down to Wellington, do a crit in the centre of the town there, or the city, and yeah, it'll be enjoyable.
Well, congratulations. Great to see you in the polka dots, and we'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate it.